know, I sat down with my accountant. He said, I got good news and I got bad news.
Okay.
I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot.
Okay.
I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more.
Okay.
Look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but in front of bait. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay. But wait, jugging on the main stage with the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacay. Meditate, hydrate. Protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up having nothing, you're labeled impatient. Whoa. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature.
Boss.
I don't want to seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster.
The city of Philadelphia is one of rich history and passion, and you can always count on the latter when you step inside Lincoln Financial Field. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Philadelphia Eagles.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Jones, first carry for the USC man, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 7.
Brady gives this one off to Jones, and give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. And just play number 3 here on the opening drive, and it's an early 3rd and 1. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And some room to roam now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
He's across midfield.
Defense had a chance to get off the field here in the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Brady on target there to Godwin. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Just one catch for him last week in the wild card win, but getting involved early here and picks up the first. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Brady. This one complete to Scott Miller. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. They go back to the ground with Jones. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3. The impressive opening drive continues, and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line, as this game gets started, as it starts to unfold, that they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
Throwing on 2nd and 3, Brady. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. 4 yards the pickup, 1st down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
On 1st down, right back to Lindsey. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 13.
Switch it.
Now he'll throw with Brady. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. Fletcher Cox breaking through to get him to the ground. It's a loss of 7. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. On 3rd and long, it's Brady. Escaping the pressure right. Looking for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own 20-yard line.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at the 20. They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. Antoine Winfield up from the secondary with a tackle.
Second and 5 at the 25-yard line.
Here's a 2nd and 5 now from the 25.
That's going to be a long down. That's going to be a long down. Kill. Check 24. Check.
Now a carry for Sanders. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Ball carrier.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go 3 and out. They're able to avoid that there.
Yeah, we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's responsibility to pay that off for them, to show respect to them. Hey, you guys got a turnover? We appreciate it. They want to continue their drive.
Flushed out right. They'll put this into the hands of Huntley. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. Second down and 3. Sanders here as they run out of the gun. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And all the way down to the 33-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It can be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last 2 plays. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
And I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
Thank you. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Now Sanders. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Mark that as a gain of 16 to set him up first and goal.
First and goal at the 2-yard line.
Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they go to work on a first and goal. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they go to work on a first and goal. They'll try to run with Sanders, and he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Things could just not have started any better for them. They get the turnover, the football right away, able to capitalize on offense for six.
And we're talking about setting a tone in any game, right? The first points of a ball game, I got during the playoffs, vitally important, and they've done that in this way.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Offense set to begin their next possession. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And yeah, I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. To throw again, Brady. Dancing to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Shotgun now for Brady. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Now Brady again. Eluding the pressure right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Again here on second and 10. Airing this one out for Evans. into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Rodney McLeod. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
They start on the ground here at Sanders. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Second and 4 at the 26-yard line.
Here's Sanders.
Miles Sanders.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
From the gun, it's Hurts. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage, too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a 3-and-out, and giving the ball back to their offense.
They're going to try and throw. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. Well, you feel the excitement build on those 4th down plays. Defense has to stay out there, but for the offense, when that thing doesn't work out, such disappointment.
It can absolutely be a deflator, but how about the defensive guys? If they stop you on 4th down, they are absolutely elevated going to their bench.
They're elevated now. Big stop on 4th down.
Darius Slay.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9.
At the Eagles' 29-yard line.
Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. They get 6. That'll leave him with 3rd and 4. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice, safe throw and a good one.
On 3rd down, here's Jones. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's 4th down.
A gain of 2 yards on the play. Brings up 4th down.
Brady to throw for it on 4th down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he is out of bounds. Looks like right at the 15. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution. A 6-yard gain, and it all works out. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10. Here's Jones. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up 1st and goal.
1st and goal, Tampa Bay.
Now Jones. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
Short of the goal.
It is definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
2nd and goal from the 1. Going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line. A big one coming in this divisional round playoff. 3rd and goal. Now the Eagles will use the 2nd of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. To throw, it's Brady sliding out of the pocket. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He got outside the pocket there trying to improvise, and he was calling for the ball downfield, but still the interception.
I think what happened, he did call for the ball thinking that he was open, but I think the quarterback spotted him too late. And that margin that he had on the defenders, that got eaten up, and they came up with the interception.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of two, and it brings up second down.
On the tackle. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he gets this down deep into Tampa Bay territory.
Sanders.
A big play there on the catch and run. And even 60 yards.
First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And he stopped immediately there.
The ball carrier.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Second down. Here's Hurts. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Marquise Goodwin there to make the grab. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. CD for them. This has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Fake the handoff. Now Brady. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. The sack backs him up, third and long. Tough challenge for Brady in the box.
Check.
From the gun, it's Brady. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And this punt sails over the sideline. And the spot, it looks to be right at the 25-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Here's Hurts to throw. They're trying for Rager, but it's intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
So first thing that crossed my mind is why didn't they just sit on the lead and take it to the locker room? They're in good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you did not need to do.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
32.
So after the INT, it's Brady. Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
On the throwaway. It's now second and 10 at the 30.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Throwing again, Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half.
Third down.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5. It's Brady. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. Fourth down now looming after Philly's defense stands tall in coverage.
Evans, incomplete.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. Right hash mark, a 42-yard attempt. Santos' kick is up and through. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC. On the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Bradley Pinion, the kickoff for Tampa Bay.
A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Certainly not what they wanted out of the locker room here as they'll start defensively at the 40-yard line. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. Hurts. He'll get this complete to Jalen Rager. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That's good for 28 yards.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Now a play fake here on first down. And a big loss here as he's taken down. William Golston able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a loss of 15 yards all told. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. Hurts sets up to throw it. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Throwing is Hurts. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 24. He's at the 40. 20. 10. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. A big play there by the rookie. An interception followed by the return for 6 points.
If you want to be accepted by your teammates and coaching staff, make plays like that.
The defense more than did its job. Now the offense is summoned onto the field as they'll go for two. From the gun, Brady. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack.
I know they didn't tack on the 2 points, but I liked their attempt. After the interception return for a touchdown, I was thinking to myself, forget kicking it, go for two, and they did.
Boy, and everybody's scrambling. Maybe you catch the defense on their heels. They weren't ready to be out there.
Yeah, it's almost like a sudden change, right? Either it's a turnover, you take it away, they stuck it in the end zone, keep the momentum going. Give credit to the defensive guys for rallying and stopping that two-point attempt.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Deep ball for Goodwin. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. This defense figured out something in the locker room. That's two third quarter picks now.
And you just wonder, did he get too comfortable in the locker room himself? His team has the lead. Take care of the football. He's putting him in jeopardy right now.
They'll start out on the ground with Jones. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Brought down at the 23 yard line. A gain of a yard. Brings up second and 9.
Again, it's Jones. Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. A third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Now Brady. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Brady now on first down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Jones hit, and the ball's out. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line.
But he has been a workhorse for them in this game, and ball security hasn't been an issue until that point.
Yeah, and let's face it, when he's going to carry the ball that many times, he becomes more and more of a target for the defense, knowing that he's going to be the primary guy. They'll just send more and more players towards him, trying to make sure they knock the ball free.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. Shaquille Barrett, what a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23.
Right there, 54, right there, right there, 54.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
They'll try and get the running game going with Jones. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
At one, and it's Brady. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 11 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
At the 3-yard line.
They'll try and run it in with Jones. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. If it was close, sneak it.
I don't think he even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
They've been in the red zone 3 times in this game and have not scored a single point. Can they break through here on second and goal? They'll try to run with Lindsey. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Bucs have taken the lead. He has been an integral part of the offense all season. And now in the playoffs, he's carrying it over. Had the touchdown last week in the wild card game. Now his second TD of the playoffs.
Showing some consistency. And that's something that we have to keep in mind about the playoffs, because we often think you have to be spectacular in order to win. I think consistent is what you're looking for that can get you to the finish line.
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. And in the third quarter here, they were trying to push that to a 3-point game, but instead it'll stay at 1.
And I'm a big proponent of not chasing points or going for 2 too early. But in this case, I understand why. You know, if you kick an extra point, you're just up 2, right? So a field goal still puts the other team ahead. So you go for 2 here and protect the field goal lead. They didn't get it done, though.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Left side here to Sanders. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Deep ball for Goodwin. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 16. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, five interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
It's a gain of 34. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves him at third and one.
Third down.
They'll go again with Lindsey. Room here to run. Past the 20. And he is finally taken down, but not before he gets it to the Eagles' 7-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Brandon, they're still in the lead, but momentum's certainly been going the opposite direction. So to me, that's a really important pickup there on third down.
Try and regain some confidence, and you're right, they need to stem the tide a little bit. That certainly helped. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line.
On the tackle.
Second and goal from inside the 5.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? Was that 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action, throw the ball.
And this time he is in.
Yes.
Punching it in from a yard away. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. He had the option to hand that football off. I think it's safe to say that he made the right decision. That was a heck of a run.
It certainly was. And when you mentioned the option, most people think the quarterback's not going to keep the ball. You know, in the NFL, that's usually not the recipe for being around too long. So when you do keep it, it often surprises the heck out of a defense.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Yeah. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And this could be the defining moment of their season, all hyperbole aside. You're trailing here in the fourth quarter, the divisional round. And they need to come up with something as they get this drive started.
The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin.
And that'll bring up second down.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. From the gun, it's Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. Now he'll pull it down. Give him seven there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. The Eagles on third down, just one for three thus far. Here it's third and three. Shotgun now for Wentz. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. When in doubt, do it yourself as he keeps it for three and a first down.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
God, it's Hurts. Oh, did he hang on to it? He did on the dive. Nice grab.
That's good.
23 yards, the final tally.
There's simply no sense in wasting a great catch like that on a short gain. Get downfield like you just did there and use it up that way.
No dink and dunk. Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Jalen Reagor was the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. They'll run. It's Sanders. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Tackle made at the 38-yard line. It's a gain of four.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Sanders.
Hurts pass.
That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
A 2 yard gain. It's fourth down.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Lavonte David. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down to make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
At the 21-yard line.
Brady gonna throw here. and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. So Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic. Third and long after that last sack. To throw is Brady. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 40. And that pick just sets him up beautifully right down near the goal line.
I remember being in a defensive meeting back when I was in college, and our defense coordinator says, we're going to call this be who you are defense. D linemen, you play the run. Linebackers, be aware of anything. And secondary, you play the pass. That way, you're all set, ready for whatever they put out there.
They'll run with Sanders. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2 yard line. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
Once again with Sanders. And he's into the end zone. No flags. It's a touchdown. And now a two-point conversion. And we'll be tied here in the final minute.
Do they have one big call left? Here we go. Apparently the week off hasn't hurt him one bit. 1,000-yard rush in the regular season. Get his first touchdown here in the playoffs. Perhaps the week off energized him.
A great article in the paper this morning basically saying that they would not have won the division without him. And he's not their only piece, but I think that's a fair statement.
It's easy to say it this way. He's their main guy.
He's back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you get a chance to take it all the way back, get 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case here, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside. And the Bucs are on this one. And that should just about do it. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Move on to the conference championship, and do you think that the printing press is starting to get those t-shirts and hats ready, my friend?
They have to, Brandon. They have to be ready, because if you win, you've got to hand those out on the field right away. And just think about the pressure for the players now. Families are going to be talking about tickets to the Super Bowl even before you play the conference championship game.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. From Philadelphia, good night, everybody.
see this mug on a billboard. Thank the good Lord, I'm getting it. Oh, overflowing with the sauce. I'm never holding back. I'm going in my coffin, middle finger poking through the casket. No paternity, tragedy to tragedy. For you knew what happened. Ain't no explanation. This is second nature. Eyeless automatic.
It's a habit, you should know it's automated. I've been getting to it, I ain't noticed y'all was hating. Brand new chick, she don't know the occupation. I just wanna know that I can hold a conversation. Oof, I don't know what y'all debating. I've been waiting for you, now I'm running out of patience. Running up a check, trying to run an operation. Went broke in the check and put 100 out of savings. I can tell now that you ain't talking about nothing. I'ma need something I can calm down from. I'm gonna pull up with the bar down one. 6 months in, I ain't once. Trying to tell me what you know about me. You don't know nothing, keep it real with me. She said she ain't trying to deal with me. Okay, cool, you can sell that seat. Ooh, and she felt intrigued. She felt intrigued. Ooh, trying to duck the LMPD. Go and get yourself a stink. And she trying to link up. So much we got synced up. Pulled up in the dinged up whip. This ain't Pepto Biz, what this pink stuff is. Go and tell me. Yeah, you heard me, you ain't feel me. I've been moving, I've been shaking. Go and hit me on the celly. Try to sell me on something while I hold it compelling. Ever since I've been gone like Kelly, they been trying to tell me about this and that. I ain't chatting with you, we ain't going tit for tat. Trying to tell me how to get in the bag. We're going to get in the bag. I'm about to get in the bag. I'm automatic is a habit. You should know it's automated. I've been getting to it. I ain't noticed y'all was hating. Brand new chick. She don't know the occupation. I just want to know that I can hold a conversation. Oof. I don't know what y'all debating. I've been waiting for you. Now I'm running out of patience. Running up a check. Trying to run an operation. Went broke in the check and put 100 out of savings. I can tell
tell now the chain talking about nothing. I'ma need something I can calm down front. I'm gonna pull up with the ball down one. 6 months saying I ain't once. Trying to tell me what you know about me. You don't know nothing, keep it real with me. She says she ain't trying to deal with me. Okay, cool, you can sell that C.
I'm a win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, I'm turning up, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating round here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I'm with the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this. Okay, just like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Aye. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Aye. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my crew, yeah. Ain't no L. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
Then I hit that.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe, one to keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that want to keep you where you've been before. But I can't go, no, I can't go. And whoa, sometimes I need a check. Not the sneakers, but the ones that make you watch your step.
You know, I sat down with my accountant. He said, I got good news and I got bad news.
Okay.
I said, what's the good news? He said, the good news is you made a lot.
Okay.
I said, what's the bad news? The bad news is you spent more.
Okay. Look, sometimes you need the faith. Sometimes you need to know your worth. Sometimes you need to wait. Shoot like the golden boy, but ain't from the bay. You can't negotiate with Drake. You gon' have to pay. But wait. Jugging on the main stage with the mainframe. Loosen up your face, baby. Sometimes I need a vacay, meditate, hydrate, protect my energy before engagement.
Grew up
Comparing nothing, you're labeled impatient. But once the boss made it, you're labeled amazing. Meticulous with words, such a force of nature. Boss. I don't want to seem absurd, but that boy's a gangster. Focusing on me, way from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle, pockets LIDs. Distinctive destinations, all I want to see. Oceanfront residences, three different ones a week. Cause I deserve that, it's time to learn that. Mess around and put that thing up where your permit. Six figures every year, yeah, I earn that. At the front of this line is where my turn at.
Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and want to see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe. Oh. Men gon' lie, women gon' lie. You're looking for the truth and the numbers don't hide. Looking for the root of all evil, then you need to go open up the briefcase, see with your eyes. Everybody claim to be great at spa times, but they never spend a day in the rain in the front line. No lie. Stop playing on my phone line. Pull up in the space coupe with the roof optional. Wonder why they follow suit. I've been groomed from the womb. Came out of my mama with some running tennis shoes. Faster than the speeding bullet. Nah, 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 nah. It's cool, it's cool. Don't play with it, play. Say, so what you gon' do?
Pick it and go. With a step on, spin move, then zone, score. Off the sideline, a touchdown, I put on a show. Kick it and go. I had to kick off and go. Kick it and go. I had to kick off and go. With a step on, spin move, then zone, score. Off the sideline, a touchdown, I put on a show. Kick it and go. I had to kick off and go. Kick it and go. I had to kick off and go.
Running it back, never a cap, out of the draft. Watch me bow, soon as I snap. Hit of the pack, wop of the sack, shaking them out, breaking them out, talking my talk, walking my wall like I do. Sit on the throne, get in the zone, turn it on, maybe the shoes, maybe the team, maybe the camp, maybe the crew. You need a win, who need a win, that's all we do. I've been a king and I've been about mine, never could doubt mine. They running the route, I leave them outline when I hit them. Drills and working the wheel where you're grinding at. You know what it be. Playing this here for the keeps. Had to make out with a feast. A family to feed. Third cold where the trophy should be. EA got me in the game now. Read on with the game now. They're here with a lane now. My home second with a rain now. Legendary on the field. Kind of drip is a skill. Just the highest cruise a bill. Ain't nothing to the heel.
With a step on, spin move.
Quarterback, shake and bake, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't
worrying about no farmers, we ain't staying there.
Let's
running
go.
Off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, six range, just like Tom Brady.
Brady.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket.
Bucket.
I just dropped the bag on the tag, ain't nothing.
Nothing.
Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me Ty, girl, it hit the hole, then I'm running. Get money,
let's go.
You ain't trying to get that second of flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
I'm in the field like a Panther, I done up the standards. Like Michael Vick in Atlanta when it's time to scramble. Neck full of water, call me Black Bridgewater. Lamar Jackson, how I throw them Ravens cross the border.
Hold up. You know I'ma touch down with the sack. Run up the whole life and running back on the play. Intercept the pack like a safety, you boys ain't shake the play. That's a flag on the play. Let's go.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket.
Bucket.
I just dropped the bag on the tag, ain't nothing.
Nothing.
Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning. Call me Ty, girl, and hit the hole, then I'm running. Get money,
let's go.
You ain't trying to get that second flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
So we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock.
Come like a bat out of hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent a message. You the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dots on you, a cheetah, run up and I'm airing the scene. I feel just like Vegeta Prince and I'm an heir to the seat.
I mean, for real. Touch the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean the man is stealing. Mean I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose thing, the fresh, but it ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a bone, me and myself top two. I blow away the competition like a ball of hot soup. And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car, my dash. I shake a pic, told them all, you ain't first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma grow that cash to my money.
They don't know my name, I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face, like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains, I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face, like it's lemonade.
They say falling and let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smell, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yo, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come on, call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes while you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
Still got a reflux, I drip out from the socket, so a teacup, drink up inside, look when they peep us, Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn, Black Hawks see the red dawn, horizon, blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction, my thoughts still rising, thinking, what type of knowledge don't sink in, life life gives you lemons and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze on each and every wave. Put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.
I got homies that can sleep without yeah. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah, drill, little bit, let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit, let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha cha macha with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, little bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit, let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
Bozo. Bozo. Really?
Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's still private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business, whole team got wins. And the wheels still spinning, I told them.
What I told them.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops. If he drop, I just hit my dance. I was top. They just watched. Had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10-10 since. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the
what?
I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the
what?
You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You better support.
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
Can I kick it? Even with a sprain, pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Change, can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Hey, could count on my power and look at my dogs. From way back then, could claim what you saw, but you weren't with us. I done got rich, then went broke, then got rich again. Just a little hiccup. I done been balling this pickup. Me being so bummy and being so hungry, I had to eat gristle. How did they let it go miss? How she remember she mixed? Met her at one of the functions, we caught a little rhythm. She caught up a friend, they kissed and we dipped it, and that's how we kicked.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? Acting different, so I ask, can I?
Before I went live, they ain't know what I was. Ain't no one alive that could do what I does. Wait. Need a light here just to catch my buzz. He's right here just to catch my car. Now they don't really talk about us. Now they don't really talk about love. Honestly, damn. What's love to a guy with a bag? What's heart to a guy with some cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said. What's broke to a guy with a mask? What's broke to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like,
let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it?
Even with a sprain, pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Damn, Cain, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might f*** it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go in water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee. Rolling thunder, don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you. If I finally starting to realize, never give up in coerce. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot, tired of trying. Go ahead and fly, everybody want a straight answer. But media keep us blind, a good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? Right, I don't got time for structure, right? I don't got time. I could it's all to what talking about. You're about to protecting themselves and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, guess I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best up the item you choose. Many times in the culture, hit you with them K-Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, with ammunition jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush off with nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I know the solution. Maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music. Just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
You'll burn out if you jump into the fire.
Marathon run, I'm a slow pace it. They did not want me to go places. Foil plans like the gold place.
And if we pull it up with the whole squad, are you ready? Then told y'all that you better be running. I'm in my goal yard. When I walk in, I know y'all telling me nothing. I'm the man. Suck it if y'all in denial. I get the chip on him and I bust out the south side. Is that Vigo de Gallo?
Boy, yo, stop it, quiet. If it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish. Masterpiece, bought it, done.
Walked in with the whole team and we ride.
my pocket. I don't want parts of your wild nonsense. We got momentum, don't try to stop it. Diamonds are clearer than my conscience. I don't let bygones be bygones. It's that's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights. Nah, that's what you call a God complex.
Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man, it feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket.
Look at the flex, yeah. Whipping the Teslas. Ooh, I'm a mess.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us in downtown New Orleans at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Atlanta Falcons and the New Orleans Saints.
Youngway Koo to kick off for Atlanta.
Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Second down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Second and nine, just a yard on that last run. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and four. To his tight end Troutman, and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Jordan Willis in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year. Second and long. Under pressure again, and down he goes again.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say, when you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. It That's a pretty good opening possession defensively.
And you know the goal is to make something of a statement, especially on the road with your first defensive possession, isn't it? Go right out and establish yourselves and let them know this is going to be tough going all game long.
And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line.
17-yard line.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Play action. Now it's Murray rolling to his right. And that'll be incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And that closed up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and 9 looming.
Third down.
They fake the handoff. Now Murray airing it out. He's gone ahead. Complete. The 30. 10. Touchdown, Falcons.
Complete. To
Calvin Ridley. 83 touchdown. Yards. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. It took them a while to get their speedster involved, but they found him downfield there.
And what we've discovered as we've watched games is the speedster doesn't have to have a lot of catches, doesn't have to have volume in order to have a huge impact on the game. His speed scares the heck out of defenses, and other guys can capitalize, but when you finally hit him and he carries it all the way into the end zone, that's what you're paying him for. That big threat that can make big plays on a limited number of catches.
That's how you step on the stage with your first catch. Take it to the house. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. This taken in about 4 yards deep, and no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. You've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
On second down, Kamara. And he'll wind up with about 6 up past the 30 to the 31.
The ball carrier.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
He'll drop to throw. Open man is the tight end, Troutman. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. He'll get about 4 here. Down to the 43-yard line.
Brady Jarrett.
With that last effort, he topples the 5,000-yard mark for his career.
And that doesn't place you among the absolute greats that have ever played the game, but it's a significant achievement and a very, very solid career.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. On play action, they'll throw. On the move to his left. And he will find his big time. the tackle's made at the Falcons 21. 22 yards on the pickup there, and it's going to yield a new set of downs. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Score, Falcons 7, Saints nothing.
Here on first down, steps away to his left, and this is caught at the end, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Adam Troutman, his first touchdown on the year, and the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
Ties the game at 7. Will Lutz to kick off for New Orleans.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it.
Oh, it's intercepted. He was trying to get it to Ridley. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. It's almost like you can see the look of frustration on his face. 4 interceptions last week. We talked about it all week. What did he do wrong? And another one here in the first half.
And you can understand the frustration. You actually feel his pain a little bit. But the worst thing he can do is what you're seeing right now, showing the other team that he's frustrated. All they're going to do is double their efforts to make him even more frustrated. He's got to gather himself, compose himself, and keep fighting.
Well, he talked a lot about erasing that loss last week, getting back in the win column. We'll see how he responds. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Now he'll escape to his right. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. The Saints on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Defense, solid coverage.
And incomplete.
Now Lutz for the field goal try. This a 33-yard attempt.
33-yard attempt.
The kick by Lutz is good. And the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
The Falcons take over 1st and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Out of the gun, here's Murray. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Demario Davis. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Will
Lakers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Lutz with the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
On the 18-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Now they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Murray off play action. Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
Murray's pass.
You give him 32 on the play.
It's a gain of 32. And the Falcons first down.
From the gun, Murray. And his throw here is incomplete. Charles, he doesn't seem to be particularly in tune with his receivers, just 2 for 7 throwing the football, but he did seem really locked in before the game.
Yeah, and that has to do with receivers sometimes. Sometimes the defenders knock them off their routes, and you're usually pretty precise. 1, 2, 3 cut, ball's out of his hands to the receiver. In this case, might be off by a half step either way. They've got to find a way to get back in sync.
Back to the air on second down, it's Murray. Buying time to his left. He'll run it. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Murray from midfield. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. First catch so far for Julio. He's got a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Here's Gurley now out of the gun. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Play fake, Murray. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they'll get this down to the 10. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. On first down, it's Gurley. There's a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
And 2 yards to go.
A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. They'll try and pick up the first with Gurley. Well, I don't think Gurley got there. Looks like the defense held him back. The defense stiffens to force fourth down following that first down gain of eight. And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and one. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. They're going for it. It's Murray. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Credit pass sack to Marcus Davenport. A breakdown by the O-line at the worst possible time. Fourth and goal, and it leads to a sack.
Hey, I can just see it now. On the sidelines, they're telling the quarterback, you've got to get rid of it somehow, some way. At least get it in the end zone and give us a chance. If we throw an interception, so what? A sack? We didn't even have a chance.
Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with exactly a minute to go before halftime. Second and four. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Now he's flushed out left. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
It's nothing like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
To his running back, it's Alvin Kamara. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and nine looming.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 17 there and a New Orleans first down.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Back to throw again. Forced out to his left. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. The play fake. He'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now.
Good
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say we'll see what happens. And likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. They'll throw now on the final play. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And this is going to be incomplete. So we've reached halftime here on Halloween. And trust me, kids, if you had to look at Charles Davis every game, you'd think every day was Halloween. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. Set now to go for the third quarter. The Saints have the lead and set to receive the kick. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. Shotgun now from Murray. He'll drop this underneath to Gurley. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Falcons have cut it to within a score. Koo now for the point after.
Brandon, they just got the ball, and already they're in the end zone, and you're getting ready to talk about the PAT. That was fast.
And his kick is right through.
Saints 17, Falcons 14.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And this carries into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
19-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin.
Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Grady Jarrett making his presence felt. He gets the sack. So they come out of the locker room trailing, but plays like that, they won't be trailing much longer. Defense really starting out well this second half.
Yeah, they knew they had to jumpstart things a little bit. They really struggled in the first half trying to slow them down, but now they had a plan, made that adjustment that we always talk about, and it worked very well on that play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Pressure gets to him, and down he goes. Back at the four-yard line, Grady Jarrett. His second sack of the night.
Brandon, more often than not, you'd say they've had his number, and we can count them up so far. 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks given up. But guess what? He's still been able to make some plays, and right now they have a lead.
Good head down running on the return. Gets about 15 yards. And the Falcons are set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. On play action, it's Murray. He'll buy some time right. Looking downfield for... And this is caught! And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta.
Touchdown.
Julio Jones with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Falcons have retaken the lead. Coup for the extra point. It's up and good to make it 21-17.
Makes the score Falcons 21, Saints 17.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Escaping the pressure right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack.
Taken down back at the 20-yard line.
Play clock down to 3, and we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. 5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on third down.
12 yards on the pickup. It's now 3rd and 3.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 22 there on the third down conversion.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Go! Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Flushed out right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Boy, the numbers throwing the football just not trending in the right direction. Last week, he was under 50%. He's under 50% again here.
And we haven't gotten an announcement, but it appears to me that he might be a little dinged up and is just trying to play through. You know, he's one of those tough guys that wants to answer the bell each and every play for his team. That might be throwing off his accuracy.
Running with Kamara. The 20, and they will finally get him down, but not before he takes this to the Falcons' 8. A big pickup of 38.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Only a yard on the game there as time will run out on this third quarter play. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. A 10th carry for Kamara. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Alvin Kamara, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Saints have retaken the lead. He's got it. And this is indeed up to a 3-point lead.
Makes the score Saints 24, Falcons.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
16-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line, and they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Aaron, it got his man complete, and he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 36 yards on the play. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Second and 11 at the 49-yard line.
Play action. Now it's Murray. Eluding the pressure right. And this is incomplete.
Murray. Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
The Falcons on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 11. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
They probably spent a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit him over the top with the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Murray's got to have this one. Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
Turnover on down.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. This now a chance at the very least to burn some clock following that fourth down stop. Points would be ideal, as they certainly wouldn't mind some breathing room. Flush to his right. He's going to take off with it. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
I like his thought process and his ability to move and get downfield. But what I didn't like was the final decision to go out of bounds. They want to keep the clock moving. Instead, they give the defense an extra timeout.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 23 yards the pickup there. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5. And the ball smacked down on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal.
Brings up second and goal.
Kamara trying again. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1.
Oh, Brandon, I'm going to tell you, this is football time to me. They're inside the 10-yard line. That's like drawing the line in the sand. Who's going to make the stand here? Defensive guys, they know if he gets in the end zone, this ball game is over. And the guys with the football right now, they're thinking, let's just pound it in there.
Got to hold him to 3 to keep this a 1-score game. They'll try to run it in with Jones. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. Only a yard there, so it brings up 4th and goal.
It's now 4th and goal.
Able to muster together a goal line stand. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. A big opportunity to tie it with 3 or take the lead with a touchdown. Their defense definitely did their part with that pivotal fourth down stop. That's complete to Smith. And he's only able to get it to right around the 3. That catch good for only a couple. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the 4th. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll roll him out right. Now a desperation throw. He's got a man complete. Oh, he's got some breathing room. Julio Jones all alone. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there.
second and goal. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches used to say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. Now we get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. For the lead, here's third and goal. They'll try and push it in with Gurley. And this time he is in. Todd Gurley, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons have taken the lead here in the fourth.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get over-eager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
The 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Well, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. He's back to throw. Being chased out left. And seeing Howard throw, he checks this one away from Howard. Incomplete. Now it's third down. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away. Live to fight another down. Smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Back to throw. Dancing to his left.
Giving up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Back to throw. Oh, no, he lost the football. fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
Escaping the pressure right. Throwing right, and that's complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. And they'll get 15, but that won't be nearly enough. It's fourth down. Down four late. Got to go for it here on fourth down. They'll look to throw again. Such little time remaining, and the Falcons defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They run, it's Gurley, and they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
Todd Gurley, the ball carrier, tackled at the 25-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup. Up second and 2.
So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for the Falcons, they move back over 500 now at 4-3. And they'll have another road day next week with the Los Angeles Rams.